Satellite imagery. Satellites are usually connected with space exploration and your internet connection, but they also play an important role in agriculture. That's because a lot of companies now provide satellite service to fields, allowing farmers to get round-the-clock aerial information on their crops. Generally, these services chart fields with 3 to 5 meter resolution imagery, and then use the data to determine a variety of crop health characteristics. To measure the status of a field of crops, they employ metrics such as the Normalized Difference Vegetation Index, Canopy Chlorophyll Content Index, and Modified Soil Adjusted Vegetation Index. The satellites may then make recommendations on how to fertilize these crops, whether chemical treatments are necessary, and perhaps most impressively, estimate crop yields before they are harvested. Trace genomics. While genetics is an area of research that is normally dominated by both people and animals, Trace Genomics is a company with a mission to extend genetic monitoring to a farmer's soil. Farmers may eliminate uncertainty by assessing whether or not an area of soil is too deteriorated to grow crops on. They analyze the biology of the soil by using proprietary soil, DNA extraction, and sequencing to index and quantify millions of microbes within it. Then, it utilizes machine learning to decode these microbes. Trace Genomics then integrates the biological and chemical data from the soil to produce a report on its strength. This allows the farmer to determine whether or not cultivating a particular plot of land will be profitable, ensuring that farming in the area is not just efficient, but also economically feasible. Terra Sentia. As robots have grown in popularity around the world, they have gradually made their way into agriculture. Although there are many examples out there, one of the finest is EarthSense's Terra Sentia robot. Primarily, this small robot rolls between the crops in a farmer's field and collects data on plant development, crop physiology, and stress reaction using a combination of sensors, visual cameras, radar, and GPS based on metrics such as stand count, stem width, and plant height. It then uses these parameters to provide farmers with detailed statistics that help them make better crop management decisions. Indoor vertical farming. Indoor vertical farming, a highly interesting new concept, has taken root in increasingly urban locations with limited land space. In terms of agriculture, this entails building vertically rather than horizontally, as it promotes individual homes and small producers to employ growing shelves to create a regulated growth environment. Now, these shelves may be used for anything from regular soil to more modern techniques like hydroponic growth, in which vegetables are grown in a nutrient-dense bowl of water, or aeroponic growth, in which free-flying plant roots are systematically sprayed with water and nutrients. CoverCress. Fields in the Midwestern United States normally go through a two-crop cycle, with corn being planted first, then soybeans, and then corn again. This approach has now been demonstrated to function, ensuring that the soil's nutrients remain steady while also providing farmers with predictable annual revenue. However, during the winter and spring months, these fields are frequently left naked, rendering them not only vulnerable to nutrient loss, but also a setback asset for the farmers who own them. CoverCress, on the other hand, hopes to improve that problem. Cress Genetics are working to turn this pretty ordinary plant into a crop that produces oil that is high in protein and similar to canola. CoverCress is unique in that it not only has the capacity to be a visually appealing product, but it is also intended to be cultivated throughout the winter and spring months when nothing else is growing. Bountigel. According to common thinking, nutrient-rich soil is necessary for food production. While this is true, Bountigel has made it their aim to increase crop yields irrespectively of whether a field is wet or dry. That's because Bountigel is a soil additive that uses patented technology in both powdered and granular forms to produce soil that absorbs up to 150 times its weight in water while preserving mechanical strength. It essentially works by storing water near a plant's roots in order to release the water into the crops in the event of a dry period, preventing them from drying out. The Farmers Business Network. Running a family farm is difficult, and small farms have always struggled to compete with large factory farms, whether it's when it comes to buying seeds, selling crops, or acquiring machinery. However, FBN aims to change this narrative. FBN is essentially an all-around tool that allows farmers to manage every financial aspect of their business with ease, thanks to a number of options that enable small farmers to truly compete with big companies. They offer an app with a price transparency feature, which allows farmers to see what other farmers price for common chemical and seed inputs. Also, FBN not only assists in finding cheap seeds, but also in finding the perfect seeds, as it provides users with yield and pricing information on over 1,400 seed kinds. Beyond these inputs, the FBN offers a variety of technology-related services, the most noteworthy of which is the free satellite imaging, which allows farmers to better monitor their fields. Drone data. Drones are commonly utilized for things like taking cool aerial videos or goofing around in the neighborhood, but they've also shown to be quite effective in the agriculture economy. That's because drones may act in a comparable way to a satellite, taking to the air to snap images and, more significantly, collecting data on a specific field using a variety of sensors. These drones' capabilities are rather astounding, since they can be equipped with a variety of sensors to monitor everything from crop health to the amount of light that crops receive. BovControl. The commercial cattle farming industry is a bit of a nightmare when it comes to dealing with large numbers of animals, as the immense number of cows that must be raised, butchered, and slaughtered can lead to severe inefficiencies in terms of not only meat and milk production, but also healthy genetics-backed breeding. However, BovControl, which bills itself as the internet for cows, has put an end to these issues. This is because this program can track almost every facet of your livestock operation. Everything from the cow's age and size to more complex information like nutritional characteristics, sanitary information, and finally the shipment of meat and milk products is tracked with it. The app tracks each cow using tattoos, ear tags, or implanted chips, with data constantly collected and fed into both management systems. After collecting this information, BovControl may create graphs and timelines that show the status of their animals, enabling ranchers to make more informed decisions about what to do next. Kray Technologies Agricultural Drone. Labor expenses are usually a source of concern for many farmers, as it is often extremely expensive to hire staff. By producing the world's first digital and autonomous drone crop sprayer, Kray Technologies have solved this difficulty. It essentially works by flying over fields and using sprayers to deliver on-demand fertilizers and pesticides directly to the farmer's fields, rather than simply spraying arbitrary amounts of fertilizer. The machine has the capability of servicing 5 square kilometers of crops per day. The agricultural drone is designed to perceive a field in 3 dimensions, allowing it to apply the correct amount of fertilizer required at the precise times. Indeed, farming technology is always developing, and if current trends continue, it will allow for increased food production and the resolution of various agricultural problems. So, be sure to like and subscribe if you want to see more of these cutting-edge farming technologies. And I'll see you next time!